Hello and welcome to Yeyu Lab. In our last video, we have learned how to create a web app with the latest version 0.80 of CrewAI framework. In that development, we used a panel as the web UI library to create an interactive multi-agent workflow app and implemented the redirecting of the agent's output and user's input messages from the command line to the front end. Panel is a powerful library for building web apps, and it is highly compatible with CrewAI. However, it's not the only option. In this video, we will show you how to create a web UI with Taipy, which is another innovative open source library for building LLM apps. As a powerful Python library, Taipy covers both backend and frontend, which initially focuses on data-driven app development, like what Panel does. In addition to the various type of elements that Taipy provides to support data visualization and interaction with very minimal coding effort, Taipy also introduces some new concepts to streamline the development process. For example, it allows user to create a web page by using markdown string like this, which can include all the necessary elements, configurations, and methods. So like this example string, which defined an entire chat component, the messages variable holds the chat history, and here is the chat component, and the users contains the list of users participating in the chat. The sender ID is set to the first user, indicating that the messages are sent by this user. And the onAction parameter is set to a function evaluate, which is defined to handle the processing of the incoming messages in a callback real-time manner. It's obvious that such type of definition is much more concise and friendly to the developers who are not familiar with Python or HTML. Another great feature of Taipy is its state concept. The state variable stores the context for a particular access for a web user. So for our UI implementation of CrewAI app, we will need to pass the output and input messages back and forth between agents and the chat UI. So using the state to carry them is a very effective way. We will see the details later in the code walkthrough. Now let's start the implementation. The final application will have the same experience as the one we built with Panel, which built the default CrewAI agents and workflows by CrewAI crew creation command, and use the web UI to wrap the app and display the agent's output and the chat history, and enable the human users to make an interaction with agents by processing the input messages at the beginning or the middle of the workflow. So first, we need to install the Taipy and the other dependencies like CrewAI. Now let's create the default CrewAI agents and workflow. As we have introduced in the last video, the CrewAI framework in current 0.80 version has introduced an automated command line to create a full-scale multi-agent applications by single command. Let's try CrewAI create crew. We can call it CrewAI Taipy project. Let's create. It asks you to select a provider to set up. Choose OpenAI and GPT-4 Mini. And then I have to enter my OpenAI API key. Now you see the CrewAI Taipy project has been successfully created, and you will find a new folder showing a well-structured project folder that you can either directly run or customize it in a very convenient way. Having the crews and workflow ready. So let's find the crew.py file in the source folder. And we will first add the output redirecting method to the agents. So in this crew.py, which is created by the CrewAI command line, you'll find that the entire crew has been defined with the name crew Taipy, and load the agents configuration and tasks configuration from the two YAML files, and also including all the agents and tasks and crews setup. If you look at the config folder, you will find this two YAML file has already been created with the agent researcher and the reporting analyst with the roles, goals, and backstory to ask the two agents to work in a sequence to generate a reporting based on a certain topic that user provided. And the tasks to define the two tasks that the two agents need to complete. The first task is to ask the research agent to give a list of the 10 bullet points of the most relevant information about the given topic. And the reporting task is to give a fully fledged report with the main topics that provided by the research agent with a full section of information and should be formatted as a markdown format. Let's back to the CrewPy file. Now in this file, we need to add this code. So here we are setting up a mechanism to handle the output from CrewAI agents and redirect it into the Taipy's UI. We defined a global variable called output handler, which will store the callback function from CrewAI Taipy. The register output handler function allows us to register the callback function, and the printout function act as a bridge to call Taipy output handler. If the output handler is set, it will code with the output from the task output, effectively redirecting the output to Taipy's UI. So we also need to import the task output. So here, the entire process is to expose the register output handler function to the main module, which will be introduced later for defining the correct Taipy display function for the output. Then we need to modify the two tasks here to register the print output callback function. So we just do callback equals print output. And here, callback equals print output. To make sure when the task is complete, the print output will be triggered to display the output message to the front end. Also, for the final task, reporting task, we need to add human import equals true, which used to enable the human user to input further instructions for the agent. So after the modification of CrewPy, let's save it, and we will move to the mem.py file to define the entire integration of workflows with Taipy UI. So as a start, let's first remove all the existing content that's generated by the default project creation of CrewAI. So first we will initiate the setup and the imports and load the .in file to load the model and the API key that we will use in the agent generation. And here you will find we import the CrewTypy and register output handler from the module of crew.py we just modified. Next, we set up the chat interface configuration. Here we defined our chat participant, human, researcher, reporting, analyst, and system with their icons, so you can put your preferred icons in this path. And the first welcome message is defined in the global conversation list, which follows the requirement from Taipy's chat component of the structure to properly display the user messages and the system messages. And then we define an onInit function that will be called in the initialization process of the Taipy framework that will copy the conversation into the state.conversation, which will be used in the entire session. Following that, we will start to manage the state and the message handling. Here we defined the update conversation function as new messages to the chat history while the create output handler creates a callback function that will be used to redirect the agent's outputs to the UI. Using the invoke callback function provided by Taipy framework, we can ensure that the callback is executed in the context of the current state, allowing us to update the conversation state display and display the new messages in a callback manner. So as what we have done in the crew module, the so-called current state is the timing when the certain task is completed. So you will find in the next implementation of the initiate crew, the first step is to call the register output handler from the crew module that makes the stage in the CrewAI workflow connected to the UI at the right moment. Let's continue the integration with CrewAI. The logic is very simple that this function initiate the CrewAI workflow from an input message as a topic, which is constructed by the crew Taipy class we defined in the crew module previously. Now the output process has been done. Let's add the human input handler part after the crew is initiated. Here is the custom function, custom ask human input, that replaces the default ask human input function in the crew agent executor mixing. We use the monkey patch method to modify the function in the runtime. In this custom ask human input function, it updates the conversation list with the agent answer and prompts the user to give feedback. It also needs invoke callback to notify the Taipy framework to update the UI immediately. It then waits for user's input in a while and returns the feedback once it's provided. The return feedback will be used for further agents generation in the CrewAI internal workflow. Okay, finally, we can define our Taipy page by using this simple markdown string. So here in the page, we include the conversation list and transform the conversation structure to a chat component and provide the users as participants in the chat and define the onAction callback as send message function, which handles the sending of the messages in the callback mode, and the sender ID as a human indicate that the message is sent by a human user, and the show sender is set to true to display the sender's name, and the mode is set to markdown to enable markdown formatting in chat messages. So let's look at the send message function. The logic is what we have introduced before with other CrewAI projects, that it will create a new thread to initiate the CrewAI workflow when a new message is sent by the human user. When the workflow is started, the incoming messages from the user input will be delivered to the user input variable, which will be processed in the custom ask human input function we defined, and also update the conversation variable to display the user input. And then the code, it initialized the Taipy GUI with this page definition and run it in the Flex server. So before we run the code, let's install our internal packages. Move to the project folder and run pip install minus e dot. Now we can run it. The web app is successfully run. For the first system message, it's asking me to provide a topic for research. So I input the mount agent as a topic. And the first agent, mount agent, senior data researcher, gives a 10 bullet points of the research areas. And then the next agent came up with the complete analysis report based on the 10 bullet points, and then asked the user to provide feedback on the final result or the agent's action. let me try, give me the top point. As a final result, the multi-agent reporting analyst gave me a top point of this report. Okay, that's a good job. And if you feel the UI appearance is too boring, you can customize it by adding a CSS file with the style definition changes of different elements that's under the Taipy chat class. Here is my quick style definition for the chat component, which simply makes the agent's output messages in a red background color, like this. That's all for today. For the tutorial and the source code, you can find the link in the description below. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Keep innovating, and I'll catch you in the next one.